An Introduction to Installing Python, Niels van Leth, University of Manchester. Okay, so this is the first introduction to a language called Python. If you already know what Python is, you probably don't want to hear what I'm doing at the moment, but you may be quite interested to see what the options are. Okay, so Python is a language which is clearly written by an organization called Python. Okay, you can clearly see it's on the website called python.org, and essentially it's an interpreted language, which means it's rather similar in many aspects to MATLAB or something like Mathematica, in the fact that you don't need to do something to this stuff first before it executes. You can just type a command and it runs. So for example, print hello I'm Python will print hello I'm Python. And there's a couple of other options as well. Now, it's a relatively easy language to learn, but essentially there's lots of things to do. Also notice there's two versions of Python, which are called typically Python 2 and Python 3. And I'll mainly concentrate on Python 2, even though many of the things apply to Python 3 as well. But the option I will suggest to install Python on your machine will actually work quite well. So, what are we going to do? Well, first we need to know how you could get Python on your machine. Python is a language that comes with many packages, and those packages all are rather helpful, and many of them are actually used for scientific usage. So for scientific usage, some people have pre-packaged those packages with Python in something that you can download quite easily. And the two most commonly used ones are the ones I've got on the websites over there. They will be all also contained in links on the website, of course. There's something called Nthought Python, and you can already see that it looks like it ain't free. Both of these things are what is called freemium, so you may have to pay something more, but since you would be the four academics, at least while you're a student, it would be fine. But the better solution, which is also freemium, but it's more freemium, which people recommend quite commonly these days, is something called Anaconda Python, which comes from a company called Continuum.io. And you can easily see, you can download it, and essentially, quite easily for either your Windows, OS X, Mac, notebook, or Linux machines, and run it on any of those. My recommendation is to use Anaconda. And that's not just my recommendation, it's based on talking to people who know more about Python than I do. The main reason is you can run it even after you would leave the university, you can install it, and it's completely free. It's only the support and some additional commercial packages that essentially would cost extra, but essentially the basic install, which is quite big and quite useful, would already be there. So what I would recommend is that you start downloading Anaconda Python, assuming you're on a Windows machine, which many of you will be. You click on Windows, and you can clearly see that you can either install the 64 or 32-bit graphical installer. I recommend you install Python 2.7 initially. There is no problem at all to install Python 3 as well later on top of 2.7, which is one of the nice designs of the Conda manager within there. But if you, of course, got no space left on your computer, there's Mini Conda as well, but Mini Conda may not be as useful because you'll have to definitely install additional packages. If you install this one, I mean, I've installed the 64-bit graphical installer on this machine, but you could do the 32-bits as well. They're slightly different in size, but essentially that's perfectly fine, and they work brilliantly well. If you want to do the same thing on OS X, no problem at all, you can do it as well. You can either have a graphical or command line installer in that case, but that's only a small difference. And if you want to do it on Linux, most Linuxes already come with Python, but if you really would like to follow what we are doing, then it's really easy to install Anaconda on a Linux machine as well. And there might even be a way to install older versions. So what you would do is you would click on the Windows 64-bit graphical installer. That then would actually, well, it downloads an enormous file, which doesn't take that long. So I'll cancel it over here because I've already installed it. And then you run that file at the end after your virus scan has run. And that's essentially it.